In this video, you will learn how to assign keyboard shortcuts to macros, system variables, and literally any command. As you might know, this is not possible in AutoCAD without having programming knowledge. However, I found a simple way to achieve this. We won't use command aliases due to its limitations. Without further say, let's start. In this example, I'll assign a keyboard shortcut to a macro. I'll use the quick revision cloud. What it does is it creates a quick revision with simply two clicks. We're gonna use the action recorder to do this. You can find it on the Manage tab, or you can type ACT record. And then you will use your macro as you normally do. When we hit stop, or when we press ACT stop to stop our action recorder, you can choose the name or the keyboard shortcut to your macro. Now, we have to tweak it a little bit so it can work on every situation and not only on this drawing. Because if we just use it without any modification to the action recorder, it's gonna create our quick revision cloud in the same location as we create our action recorder. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click where it says insertion point, and we're gonna do pause for user input. The same thing in here. Now, we're gonna test our new keyboard shortcut for our macro, RC, and boom. How neat is that? So you assigned your first keyboard shortcut to your macro. Now, second example, we're gonna use our make unique block macro. As you can see, these doors are the same. I'll do the same process, record or ACT record, and I'll use my macro as I normally use it. When I hit stop, I'll assign the keyboard shortcut that I want for this specific macro. Now, I'll have to tweak it a little bit so it can work for any block and not just for this one. So again, pause for input so it can work with this or the other block. And here we see that we have two flattened. We don't need this, so we will remove it. And we're gonna test our keyboard shortcut. And boom, we're gonna edit this block just to see that our keyboard shortcut really worked. So it actually did. Again, you can find the make unique block macro in my other tutorials. In this third example, I'll assign a keyboard shortcut to a system variable. I hate to type image frame all the time because it's so long. So again, I'll record it. And then I'll assign my keyboard shortcut, IF, simple. So now, if I type IF, oops, you saw that nothing happened. Why? Because we forgot to tweak it a little bit. So here I will pause for input again. And now, if we use IF 0 to turn off the image frame, or 1 to turn it on. How neat is that? As you can see, you can assign any keyboard shortcut to any of your favorite tools, macros, and any command. The last example is wipeout frame, which I assign it the shortcut WF. So wipeout frame on and wipeout frame off. How neat is that? For more tricks, subscribe, comment, and share, because we are lazy, lazy, lazy.